Fala galera, diretamente da Barra do Saí, fazendo uma entrevista com meu amigo e brother da Austrália, de Melbourne, Adam Valastro. Ele é fundador e idealizador do projeto Traveling Tradies, que é uma plataforma que você troca suas skills, suas habilidades em manutenção em obras por receptividade, né? Por uma hospedagem e por um pouquinho uma alimentação também, né? Uma troca justa, algumas horas por dia. Para fazer uma obra para você, ou um ajuste, ou qualquer necessidade que você precisa reparar na sua propriedade, por uma caminha quentinha, confortável, e também por uma alimentação. E a entrevista vai ser em inglês, então fica ligado que a gente vai botar a legenda aqui embaixo também. Hey Adam, how are you, mate?
I'm good, bro. How are you?
Good. What time now is Melbourne?
It is 10 to 9 p.m. on a Tuesday evening.
10 to 9,
That's it. 10 to
yeah,
9.
here's te so it's 10 to 8, so it's 11 hours difference.
Yeah, or 13 maybe.
Yeah, man, so ready to go to bed?
No, not yet. I got a couple more hours of work to do. You know what it's like. Thank you for the lovely introduction in Portuguese. I got some of it.
I know you understood something.
That's it.
So, Adam, I just said a little bit and really short introduction of traveling tradies. So tell us what traveling tradies is.
Yeah, cool. So two parts to that, right? So Traveling Tradies originated as an international double-sided marketplace, so where we basically connected Australian qualified construction workers with venues like hotels and hostels from around the world, and they swapped their skills for food and accommodation. So since COVID, and obviously here in Australia, and a lot of other countries as well, they've shut down all international borders. So our business overnight literally came to a grinding halt. As a result of that, we basically transitioned to a local business model where we focused on venues in Australia. So predominantly hotels, hostels, but mainly Airbnbs, booking.com, that kind of stuff here. And it's been amazing. It's been a slight tweak of platform, a slight tweak of revenue model, business direction, strategy, things like that. But as a whole, we had the database of tradies already. The only thing that we had to restart was the database of venues. So we've really
So
ramped that up.
is he allowed to travel around Australia in this moment?
So it depends what state you are in. So at the moment in Victoria, you can't travel anywhere. You're in Melbourne, especially. We're in stage four lockdown. The other states that we have, so Queensland, Western Australia, South Australia, Northern Territory, New South Wales, and Tasmania, are relatively unaffected, but they are state specific. So again, our business model had to change where we couldn't necessarily send tradies to different states, but travel within their own state for now.
But it's good because you could work with your tradies. Okay, you could get some tradies
Yeah.
to join the platform. So
Correct.
next stage would be worldwide, right? So we can
Yeah. So
apply and get new places around the.
we did it backwards a little bit. So we started international and now we're to local, which is okay. Like it forced us to do so. But now we can be more interactive on the ground, and we can be more responsive, and we can be more, customer service can be more paramount, which is great.
Especially it's good to get some experience
Yeah.
and get a good database for tradies in Australia. It's an Australian platform, so that's
Correct. Yeah.
good. I mean, sometimes you have to step back a little bit to go forward faster, right?
Yeah, slow down to speed up, as they say. And I think here we got a lot of media coverage, we got a lot of support, we've got some funding now, which is great. But that took time. Like that took a lot of time to really build that brand credibility and brand awareness in the market. And here in Australia, people are very, what's the word, skeptical of new things.
I think everywhere, right? It's a new business model, right? I mean, you have the volunteer platforms like Woodpeckers, Workaway,
Workaway, yeah.
Helpx, this kind of thing, but you're specifically for people with certain skills. So that's very, very nice. And then I think everybody needs that sometimes, help with something. So
yeah, everywhere in the world needs things fixed and repaired, right? And
especially, to be done.
things in different venues like, different hostels and, from your own knowledge, there's always things to be fixed because there's always people coming in and out, you know?
Yeah. And then, now I'm going to say in Portuguese, so just a minute. Pessoal, o Aaron foi com um sócio dele, ou pelo menos o idealizador, vou até perguntar para ele agora se mudou alguma coisa. Vieram ao Brasil e fizeram uma rota aqui em alguns hostels, com contato intermédio de um amigo nosso que a gente vai visitar, que é o pessoal do Green Haven. Eles intermediaram, eles foram a alguns hostels e fizeram alguns serviços. E um deles foi o Iolo lá em Búzios, foi assim que a gente se conheceu. Então, é um trabalho super qualificado, de pessoas que estudaram anos para poder fazer o que fazem. E pessoas super de boa, viajados. Então, assim que eu conheci o Aram, assim que a plataforma funciona. E é bem bacana, a proposta é bem bacana. É uma coisa, não ele vai trabalhar como voluntário no bar, ou na recepção, ou interagindo com os hóspedes, ou cozinhando. Ele vai trabalhar focado no que ele trabalha, o que ele estudou para fazer, né? Como encanamento, elétrica e qualquer outra coisa que ele saiba, que ele tenha o know-how, o conhecimento que ele estudou em troca da acomodação e alimentação. Could you get it?
Yeah, I understood most of it. In Green Haven introduced us. We came to the hostel. We fixed some things up. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Daddy came to Brazil, stayed at Iolo.
Yeah.
Green Haven introduced us, connect us.
I got the drift.
So tell me, when did you have this idea? I mean, why this idea came to you? When that happened? When it came to you? Pop out in your mind, like, oh, I have an idea.
Yeah. So it's a really interesting
question.
A lot of people go, oh, I could never think of an idea like that. But to be totally honest, it was bred from experience. So just for a little bit of backstory, I'm a plumber by trade and I worked in construction for about 12 years. And then I got to a point in construction where I couldn't really grow anymore. And I wasn't using my mind very much. So here in Australia, construction workers get paid very good money. But I got to a point where I had all this money and all these things, but I was still miserable, right? And for me, it was a big part of, one, my mental health, and two, kind of where I wanted to grow, one, in my life, and two, what I wanted to develop as a person into. I was very lost. I didn't have any guidance. I didn't really have any idea. And honestly, it's a bit of a sad story, but after two friends of mine actually took their own lives in a very short amount of time, that was kind of my catalyst or my decision to be like, fuck this. I'm not going to do this anymore. I'm going to try something different with my life.
And it's changed my life, right? It's
And
at some point you have to do something.
So, and this is the saddest part, I think, Gabriel, is sometimes it takes a real tragic event for people to make change, when if we can just be conscious of the decisions that we're making, we can maybe avoid pain. And if we can avoid pain and still make the good decisions, then that's a win, right? So for me, it was I resigned from my job. I booked a ticket to South America and I basically disappeared around the world.
And when was that?
That was 2014.
2014. Yeah. 6 years ago.
Yeah. So 2014. And then I traveled all through South America, Central America.
I'm trying to make a photo. Sorry.
No problem. Traveled all through South America, North America, a little bit of Europe and Asia. And then for about three and a half years. And in
three
that
and a half time, years.
Yeah. So in that time, though, this is where everybody goes, oh, you must have spent lots of money and you must have did this. Actually, what happened is I approached hostels like Vinny and Green Haven. Uh-huh. I approached other hostels around South America and Europe. And I basically said, hey, you've got things that need to be fixed. I can fix them. Why don't you give me a bed and I'll do it for you for free? And then that's literally how the idea started to come. Plus, like you mentioned before, platforms like Workaway and Worldpackers were there. and I utilized them to connect to people, but they didn't always offer things that I could offer. So for example,
I understand it.
Yeah. Handyman stuff or painting or fitness or whatever. So that was where I kind of found the gap. Not only about that, when I came back to Australia, everybody that I spoke to that was in my industry was like, wait, hang on a minute. You traveled and you could use your skills. Why can't I do that? And more and more and more and more people said that. I went, you know what? This could be something. Totally honest, I had no idea about business. I had no idea what I was doing. I had no idea how to even create something like this. So for the first 2 years, it was me learning. It was me educating myself. It was me grinding. So it took me, I had no idea about business. I had no idea what I was trying to create. I had no guidance. I had no understanding. But what I did have, Gabriel, was a resilient attitude and a decision that I wasn't going to go back to working in construction because I knew I would be miserable. So my driver was so strong that even though I had no idea what I was doing, and for 2 years, I kind of ran around just doing shit, but not the right things. But that's how I learned, right? I didn't give up. I always educated myself. I found people that could help me and provided them value. Mm-hmm. And then I basically just started to build the business slowly, slowly, slowly. And like, to be totally honest, like even now there's things about the business that I have no idea about. Yeah. And that was the thing I had, because I didn't know anything and I didn't know where to look and I couldn't afford to just hire people. Yeah, I had to learn. Right.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I literally just educated myself. I went to seminars. I listened to podcasts. I read books. Mind you, I hadn't read a book in about 10 years. So it took me a long time to build up certain habits to be able to fulfill the desires of what I wanted to create. And that was
not easy. If you stay, you said before you travel around South America and Europe and Asia, you not using a lot of, thinking a lot. You weren't using your brain that much. You're just doing renovation things.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean that you don't use your brain. Of course you use it, but you know, you're not getting to books or studying new things.
Yeah.
Probably it's what you said.
It was repetition. It was repetition in construction. Yeah. It's all physical labor and a little bit of thinking, but not much.
And then you come back and then have to get these habits and then get used to it. It's hard. And then, but once you do it, start building this, you start reading faster and then more and more. And if you like, you have the audiobooks as well. So it's very important, especially for me, in this quarantine, is when the idea came, like said, I don't know, it's life showing me that you might not be here tomorrow. So why not do what you like, what you feel that you like? It is traveling, talk about environment, culture, and connect people. And then trying to connect to new destinies, new places. It's one thing that I notice a lot here. It's people travel and they to places that they see on Instagram. Shit, the sun is too high right now. Just let me move it a little bit. And then they want to have the same picture that everybody has. And then there's a lot of other places, a lot new cities to be discovered close to that ones, beautiful places. And then no one's talking about. People could be working with tourism in these cities, making money, their lives, and then change the economy a little bit. And then why not? Let's do it. And then in the way, try to connect people. And that's what I want to do. It's what I realize that I'm really enjoying doing. It's connecting people. That's quite nice.
Yeah.
So sometimes you need that. You know, that life shake, like, you know, this change in perspective to see, you can always keep in your mind some excuses like, oh, it's hard. These people they do that because we have a lot of Instagrammers or traveling digital nomads that are saying, oh, it probably started before, or I don't know, they are models and they have some background or something that helped them to do that. But now they just, I don't know, had a new, some plan, they created something, and then they just
done it. Yeah.
Went.
This is the thing, though, right, man? People see someone at a level of success, whatever that is, to everybody, it's different, right? Whether it's financial, whether it's relationship, whether it's whatever. People look at people through Instagram and they go, oh, you know, they're so talented, or they're so this, or they're so that. And you're like, well, hang on a minute. You don't know anything about their backstory. Nothing, right? And people like create a business. Oh, you know, they can do whatever they want because they've got money. And it's like, well, a lot of good business owners that do good things, not shit companies, but good companies, have built themselves from nothing. And if they've built themselves from nothing, it didn't just come out of thin air. It came from self-growth. It came from learning. It came from resilience. It came from connection. It came from network. It came from drive. It came from all these components put together. And I think this is the hardest part for people, is people want instant gratification, right? I've been grinding on this business for 3 years, man. Like, I've got another 10 to go, and I'm willing to do that because I love it with all my heart. And the reason why I love it is because every day it challenges me. Every day I grow. Every day it's something different. But at the end of the day, it's a conscious choice that I've made to do it. I don't get told when to wake up. I don't get told when I have to be at work. But I force myself to maintain good habits, or else I'll accomplish nothing.
Yeah.
And that's the formula, if you so desire.
Yeah, good habits, and then you have to do that. You have, it's not because you're on boss that you don't have to do a routine. You don't have to do, you know, work, study, and then study more and do. It's always good also to do some exercises.
Yeah.
To focus, to help you focus. Yeah, for sure, man. It's as I keep saying, that if you'd like it, study a little bit, invest your time in studying, and sort of plan, and then do it.
Yeah, exactly.
At some point, you're gonna turn this out. Shit, I'm shaking the table here. Yeah, man. But it is amazing, the idea. You took something that was hard, like a bad experience,
yeah,
and turn it into a good experience. And then during this experience, like traveling, you came with this great and amazing idea. Now it's a platform, it's working your ass off, but it's worth it, right?
Yeah, 100%.
You probably lay it down, you put your head on your pillow, and I say, fuck, it was a good day.
Yeah.
I grew as a person, I grew my company. And yeah, I'm gonna do what I like, and helping people as well. Because as you said, two friends of yours took their own lives because they're probably stressed. They probably had a burnout syndrome or something like that.
Yeah.
And then I think people in that business, construction business, they probably had a lot of stress levels.
Yeah.
They had to work a lot of pressure.
Here in Australia, it's a little bit different because there's a very big toxic masculinity culture here in construction. So there's money, so you get paid very well. There's a very big masculine culture and very toxic. There's a very big mentality around kind of there's hierarchy. So there's a lot of problems in the industry, but there's also not a lot of support or a lot of guidance, right? If somebody says, hey, I'm feeling shit, they like, oh, don't be weak. Or, you know what I mean? It's like, well, hang on a minute. It doesn't necessarily have to be like that. So, you know, as you know, a big driver for me is to be able to change this mentality around different things and different people. And I think it's from what you said before, from burnout. It comes from being exhausted. It comes from not exercising. It comes from not looking after your mental health. It comes from not educating. And all of these little components come together, cause exponential growth in a negative way. So if you can create healthy habits, if you can create healthy mindset, and don't get me wrong, not every day is picture perfect. Some days I wake up and I finish the day and I'm like, that was horrendous. But you go to bed, you wake up with a good attitude, you do some exercise, you sweat it all out, you get ready and you crack on again.
It's what is important, not giving up and then say, not every day is going to be perfect.
Yeah, correct.
It's never going to be perfect. It can be perfect. Otherwise,
what's the point, huh?
Exactly. You don't have to fight for something. You don't have focus. You don't have a dream and stuff. But Adam, how traders can apply, can go to join the platform?
Yeah, so go onto our website if you sign up at travelingtradies.com. We basically take you through a series of a verification process, and then we'll link you into our main platform, which we're in the next stages of our test phase for the local model here in Australia. And yeah, we just take it away from there. We get you through the process. We make sure we're a right fit for each other. And then, we welcome you to the platform.
And that works for accommodations as well, like inns, hotels. As well.
Go to the website. There's a
website.
Travelingtradies.com. There's a host button on the side. Even international hosts at the moment, we're still bringing them on. Obviously, depending on what happens with COVID and Australia's borders, will dictate what happens for a little bit. But, always open to build relationships, make connections, answer any questions that you may have. Feel free to reach out anytime.
Networking is always important, right?
That's it. Network is your net worth, as they say, Gabriel.
Net worth?
Yeah. Your network is your net worth.
Yeah, that's good. And then to finish, Adam, explain how specifically for people in these business, in the construction business, what especially for them, but you can say in general as well, but why traveling is so important to people?
Yeah.
What that brings to you that is good? Tell us in your opinion.
Yeah. So my opinion, for starters, let me just start that for me, travel changed my life, right? Travel really gave me a shift in perspective of places, people, culture, food. It gave me an understanding of problems. It gave me a level of, a stage to be able to go. Here in Australia, for example, we're a beautiful, lucky country, right? We're a first world country. And here, when you're stuck in the bubble and we're quite isolated from the world, things that aren't a problem become a problem. And let me give you an example. Here in Australia, a cold coffee is a problem. In life, a cold coffee is not a problem. Not a problem at all.
Not at all. Right?
People shooting at you on the way to school, that's a problem, right? People not being able to eat. That's a problem.
Starving to death, yeah.
That's a problem. So for me, it really shook up everything in my blood, my mind, my soul. And it really gave me a different perspective and an understanding of all these things so that when I came back to a place like Australia or when I travel somewhere else, I always see it from a different lens. And I always judge things and go, okay, I'm feeling emotional about this, but is it really worth my time and energy to feel emotional about that, whether it's a good or bad emotion, right? So it just gave me, it unlocked parts of my mind, body, and soul that I don't think would have got anywhere else. And I genuinely believe that everybody should go out and travel and everybody should be put out in their outside of their comfort zone, because when you travel and you're put outside of your comfort zone and the only person that you can rely on in some situations is yourself, it not only builds and grows your character exponentially, it gives you that totally shift in perspective to be able to grow as a person forever.
Yeah, I understand. And it's perfect, man. Getting out of a comfort zone is always important.
Yeah.
And traveling really can change your mind.
For sure. Most definitely. Everyone you meet, I agree. Places you go, for sure.
And as you said, you see things in a different lens. Different perspective, and then probably you understand better the world, and then also you can see how lucky, how fortunate you are to have a house, food,
correct,
and then as you said, a cold coffee is not a problem. You can just put it back in the microwave and heat for a little bit, and then
not a problem.
Find a solution, and then
and that's something
you did that. You did that. You travel so the world and then have a different perspective, and then you change, you find a solution for a problem. That's how good ideas
come about.
Come about, exactly. It's like you found a solution for a problem, which is people stress working and say, why not? I can travel and then I can save some money in accommodation in exchange for a few hours of my job. And also meeting new people, chatting with people from different countries, different economic situations, different cultures. You see life, different perspectives of life.
Yeah.
It's perfect, man. It's perfect.
Yeah. And same thing what you were saying before about the solutions, right? So it's a lot of times people just create problems and you say, okay, cool, it's a problem, but provide me a
solution. It's easier to create problems. Yeah.
Yeah, it's easy to create problems. Exactly right. But I will never create a problem unless I've already created a solution.
As I used to say at back in YOLO, I said, okay, whining, complaining about the problem. I know the problem already. You know the problem already. Yeah. So why, instead of bringing me the problem,
bring me a solution.
You don't bring me a solution. Okay. Could be a shitty one.
Yeah.
I wonder what won't work, but at least it said, oh, we have a Houston, we have a problem, but I think you can fix it with this.
Exactly.
No, you cannot fix it with this. So I can try that. And then,
different
it's better because you put some positive energy in your attitude, in your voice, and you said, it's not like, oh, fuck, we have a problem. That happened again. So
being
shaken, man, tell me.
Yeah.
Be proactive. Tell me, what do you need? What the problem is that? You know, how does it work? I know. So how can we fix it? Okay, so doesn't work. Let's try something different. We cannot fix it. Let's call someone who can do it.
Yeah,
and then you need to move. I always move. Otherwise, you're going to be stuck in the same place.
Stuck in the quicksand.
Exactly. Just going down, being drowning in the quicksand. Perfect, man. Aaron, it was amazing to see you again.
Always.
Have this chat with you. We always had this connection of changing, thinking a little bit.
You
look like the same. It's always good to talk to people who have this perspective.
Thank you, bro.
I hope that people can enjoy this interview. And then because now it's in English, you can send to some Australian friends or English speakers.
Share it to me, man. I'll share it around
the world. Yeah. And see if they can change their mindsets and start building good habits. And then when they can travel. So if they're from Australia, they can join a platform as well.
Yeah, of course.
And then do some good. Do you send it to themselves and to other people?
And then around the world when we can again.
In a few months, hopefully.
Hopefully. We'll see. Thank you, bro. Appreciate it.
Thank you, man. Me too. Pessoal, espero que tenham gostado aí do vídeo. Quem ficou até o final, quem curtiu. Se não curtiu, curte a gente aí. Curte o vídeo, segue a gente. Curte e segue Traveling Traders também. Fácil de achar no Instagram, tá? Nas redes sociais. E é isso. Espero que tenha gostado. Beijo. Até o próximo. E agora, com esse sol que vocês já viram aqui, ó, a bela face está iluminada, vou pra praia. Valeu?
Valeu.
See you guys.